I'm Peter Brown from Tiny & Sons Glass. Tiny & Sons Glass was established in 1978 with my father and brother and I. We're at 575 Washington Street in Pembroke. We're certified and qualified to do all your windshield replacement and repair. Tiny & Sons Glass is a community-based business. We have 12 mobile vans that come to you. If the weather's bad, you can come here to the shop. We have a nice waiting area, TV, Wi-Fi, kid-friendly, pet-friendly. We also can move about 15, 20 cars a day through the shop. Perfect for you when the weather's bad. So come on down to Tiny & Sons Glass if you need your windshield replaced or repaired. Tiny & Sons Glass, 1-888-64-TINIES. Just call. Thank you.
I'm Arthur Boyle of Performance Appraisal Services. We're residential real estate appraisers with a company founded in 1994 by Mike Gianelli and I in the basement of my house in Malden. We've since grown to have offices in Malden and Pembroke. We serve the eastern Mass counties, including Cape Cod. A good client for us is an attorney or a private landowner or a private property owner who's going through a probate process or a divorce division of property. Call us at 781-293-6900. Ask for Arthur Boyle or Amanda Boyle Grazioso. Our first name is Performance.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Pembroke Board of Selectmen's meeting of Wednesday, February 15th. And we'll begin the meeting with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please note that this meeting is being made available to the public through a live video and audio broadcast on Comcast Government Access Channel 15 and is being recorded for broadcast at future dates. Comments made in open session will be recorded. First item on our agenda is to vote to open the warrant for the annual town meeting May 9th, 2017.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Arthur, second by Bill. Any questions? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Can I just call your attention, board members? On the second page of this is a list of dates that we must adhere to in order to be prepared and ready for the town meeting. We need town reports and photos and so forth. It's self-explanatory, but Sabrina puts this out and she is looking for us to adhere to this schedule, so we will be ready. Thank you. Next item on our agenda is a letter from the Recreation Committee to please consider the request of the Recreation Commission to vote to accept the donation of Paul Norse and his family for the placing of a memorial bench dedicated to Carol Norse on the town green. Mrs. Noss has passed away, and her family, due to her many years working for the Recreation Commission and other departments in the town, to honor her memory with this bench on the town green.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, Dan.
Vote to approve with gratitude.
Second.
Thank you very much, Dan, and second by Arthur. All those in favor, please aye. Say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, that's unanimous. Next item for us this evening is to consider a one-day liquor license, the Pembroke Historical Society event on Sunday, April 2nd, from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion by Arthur and a second by Dan. Are there any questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, hearing none. Unanimous. We have a request of the Pembroke Historical Society for the use of Thomas Redding Park at the Herring Run, May 7th, 2017, from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion by Arthur, a second by Dan. Any questions?
I have a question, yeah.
Yes, Bill.
It says the Conservation Commission must approve the event, and they have not met yet. And the other thing I just want to put in there, that they should get a hold of the Pembroke Herring Fisheries Commission, Commissioner, and request approval if they're going to do their duck race this year.
Okay, can we...
Take those as friendly amendments.
Second.
Yes. Okay, we have a friendly amendment that's been seconded. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, hearing none. Deem that to be unanimous as well. We have the minutes of January 23rd before us. Do I have a motion on those minutes?
Move to accept this written.
Second.
A motion by Arthur to accept, second by Bill. Any questions from the board? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? I rule that to be unanimous as well. Under old business, do we have any issues we would like to discuss on the River Marsh application for a 40B project on Water Street?
I would defer to the town administrator. And I will defer to the executive assistant who's been putting on the response for the town. I think at this point, we have all the information that we've asked for, with the exception of a couple of departments.
Two small departments that are working on it now, the Division of Marine Fisheries and potentially the Scituate Conservation Commission will be weighing in to the effect of the North River on the surrounding.
So other than that, when we get those, we're ready to go.
Yeah.
And we have received another date to get this all in, which is very favorable to us, and we thank the housing department for that.
The only thing I'd like to say is that Saturday's meeting opened up a lot of eyes and ears to a lot of other things that seem to be going on in that project. So it was good that we had that meeting Saturday, because it there was a lot of other things that we probably didn't consider that will probably be in that letter. So.
Could you discuss that further for folks that were unable to make that meeting, Bill?
Well, it was probably about an hour and a half or better meeting. It was very well attended by quite a few people. The room here was probably three quarters full of people, and there was just a lot of things that brought up. I don't have my notes here with me tonight exactly everything that was gone over, but it was very well attended, and there was a lot of things discussed. One of the things was that I had talked to the Division of Marine Fisheries. They're very concerned with it, and they want to have input into that. But they're under policy that they need a proper plan and all that to make a presentation. And when I discussed that with the area representative, I advised them that this plan was made in 2002. Or was designed from 2002. And the natural bank delineation wasn't done properly, from what I understand, back then. And as you look into more and more things that people brought up, it's it was good to have the meeting, and it was good to see that everybody is on board. And somebody asked a question about, is there anybody that is for the project? And so far, we haven't received one response from anybody anywhere that's for the project. Mm-hmm. So it's we're hoping that the thing about the Division of Marine Fisheries, they go in and do a study in that whole area, but they have to do it according to their plans, and unfortunately, it can't be a quick decision. It has to be the proper plans, they look at the plans, they go in and the area has to be flagged, they have to look at everything and measure everything and all that other stuff. So it's, they look for endangered species and a lot of other things that have been brought up. So it's kind of important that they have an input into it before Mass Housing makes a decision, oh, okay, it's okay, go ahead, go in and fill the land and put the project in. So it's hoping that they put that off and take everybody's concerns into consideration before they even make a temporary approval of it. So.
Right. That triggered a memory of mine. Ed, could you take this down as a note? The one thing that we may object to for the plan also is that the survey plan that they have was done by a certified land surveyor. Bernie Monroe, I expect, was the man that did it, but it was land planning. They're not civil engineers or environmental engineers. So there may be a question about the wetlands delineation.
I saw a comment to tack on to Bill's comment for the folks at home, because I know the cameras weren't there on Saturday, but we discussed great environmental concerns, safety concerns, and like he had mentioned, planning concerns about this project.
And a lot of things that were brought up about floodplains and whatever, you know, we've been able to get a lot of information from the health agent and from the chief assessor regarding, so there's a lot of maps that are going with our civil as well as that.
Arthur?
Yeah, there were some things, Dan, that were interesting that were pointed out to us that we didn't necessarily not know, but, you know, it was news to me in some cases. The historic value of the area and the environmental consequences of doing this and not being able to undo it. And you had water runoff and fertilizer runoff into the North River, which is a problem that we've tried to avoid in the ponds that would be recreated in the North River. So there was a number of things. One of the things that I didn't know was that one of the ships that was in the Boston Tea Party was built down at the end of their neighborhood. And
that was the Beaver.
What's that?
That was the Beaver that was in the Boston Tea
Party. It was the Beaver, is right. Yeah.
That's on the town logo.
Yeah, and the Columbia was there, and there was another one, the Maria, that was used in another historic sense. But anyway, the road layout, and I think Matthew touched on this, if you're coming north on 139 to make the right onto Water Street, unless you're riding on a moped, you're not going to make that turn clean. It took, in my pickup truck, it took one cut to come back and, you know, go forward. And, you know, in a small car, you might be able to do it, but you're definitely going to cross the yellow line. And there's been 43 accidents, Sabrina, in the last
couple months.
In 3 years.
So all of the legitimate arguments are being made. I think there's no question about it, and Bill's point is well taken. Nobody's yet to come forward to say, I think this is a great idea. It's not a great idea. It's a bad plan. It's at a bad spot. And hopefully we'll have Mass Housing see what we see.
And we do have a letter that came in from Josh Cutler that was really good. And we're waiting on a letter from Vinny DiMacito and some other people that are very concerned with the North River's protection also. So.
Good. Anyone else with comments? Thank you. We will move on to the town administrator's report. Ed?
Because of advisory canceling their meeting Monday night, I'll be presenting the town budget, the preliminary first step on the 27th to advisory, and we'll share that with the Board of Selectmen that night. Currently, it's balanced, but it's not pretty. You know, there's a lot of concessions that the town accountant and I made regarding revenues. You know, we maxed out the several categories in the local receipts. to balance the budget. Right now, we have a level service budget. In a related matter, Mr. Buckley, Ms. McCarthy, and myself attended the Mayflower Steering Group Committee. They still discussed split rates and a blended rate for FY18. It appears that they were not in a position to make a recommendation to the general membership today, so they reset their meeting for March the 2nd, so at 9 o'clock, and then I'll meet with the Insurance Advisory Committee, which is representatives of all the union. Obviously, we're not doing it next week because it's school vacation, and also we wanted to make sure that we got a definitive word from the steering committee about what they're going to recommend to the general membership. The general membership is scheduled to meet in Halifax on March the 23rd, in which they'll vote on the rates for FY18. So a lot is riding on the rates that are voted on by the total membership. If the difference between 19 and 11% is it's over $500,000 to the town. And so that's going to go a long ways in determining what kind of budget we'll have going into town meeting. So that's where we are right now.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
I see Mike Damon from the Chamber of Commerce sitting in the audience, and he was going to present a pitch to us on Monday night, and we got snowed out, so I would request that he be permitted to address the board at a time that's convenient for you.
Very good. Well, Mr. Damon, would you be available right now?
I would be available.
Good. Thank you. Would you come up front to the podium?
Well, first of all, thank you for having me before the board. I've been on for probably the longest of all of the board members. Through gentleman Joe Delmonico, I met years ago, and Joe had worked with me in my accounting profession. Bill, I've seen at chamber events. Ed and Dan, you've been welcome umpires and participants at our meetings in the past. Lou, I always enjoy having you sing at church, as I've mentioned before. You've got a great voice. If you haven't heard him sing, fantastic. Really enjoyed it. I've been a resident of Pembroke since 1994. I've had my business here, two businesses now, for 5 years. I used to be in Marshfield. I'm a Scituate guy, grew up in Scituate. We go back, our family goes back to about 1630 in Scituate. Happened to notice one time when I was in town hall with the Boy Scouts, there happens to be a Damon in the, wherever the Civil War pictures are, there's a Damon in there as well. So, and, I remember meeting Les Damon one time in town as well. But, been in town with three boys, raised, all went through the schools, great kids. Great school system, very pleased with the results. I have one more in college now. My wife Kelly, and we'll be married 25 years this year. So I'll just give you a little background on the Damons of town. As I said, I own two businesses. I have Damon and Associates, soon to be renamed Damon Diodati and Company. We are a CPA public accounting firm, and we do primarily work with individuals and small businesses, helping them with their compliance filings, tax filings. We do financial statements if they're required by usually the lending institution or by the shareholders of that company. We kind of specialize in small businesses. Small business for us is anything from 0 to $50 million in sales. But most of our, I'd say our bread and butter are our clients that are doing $1 million to $5 million in sales. We do a lot of individual work. We do a lot of planning with our clients. We don't wait for April 15th to come around and say, oh, this is what you owe. Those clients that require, especially with businesses and flow-through entities that flow through them, those of you that are in business are familiar with those terms. We are very active with them before the end of the year. Is there anything we can do, or anticipate what's going to be due, or income's dropping, well, you may want to do some things that accelerate income to bring that in. So we do a lot of work very closely with our individual and corporate clients. We do a lot of consulting with them. You know, a lot of times, as we all get older, we, especially now that I'm 58 years old, we talk about succession planning a lot with our clients, you know. We've had a few of our clients' businesses turn over this year, helping them through that process, selling the business, preparing it to be sold. And that could be internally to a family member, could be their employees, or someone on the outside. And there's various issues that come up with all of those things. So we help clients in. We work with them, what we call KPIs, key performance indicators, statistics, you know, what's important to your business. You know, are you on an upward trend, a good trend, a bad trend? What can we do about it? You know, and try to share our knowledge of different businesses and bring that to the table. I had two of those meetings today, you know, with clients. So it's not just tax compliance, that's the boring stuff that we do. The fun stuff is working with clients, helping them to grow their businesses, helping them improve their businesses. The other company that we have is PowerPoint Wealth Management, named after the famous bridge. And people say, well, how did you come up with that name? And it was just when I was a teenager, we used to hang out down there a lot, down at the bridge, and always liked that name. And I said, you know, someday. And so sure enough, I created a wealth management company. I've been licensed for securities and insurance securities over 20 years. I had a client, I told the story today to a lawyer, that it was a retired airline pilot from Situ who got me to go get my license, my securities license, because he wanted me to manage his money. I said, I couldn't, I'm not licensed. He said, I've been licensed. So I did. And so we help people manage their money. We help them, you know, plan for retirement, plan for college savings. We help them with life's events. I deal with a lot of older clients. I have four women clients that are in their 90s, and some of them have family nearby, some don't, and so we help with that. And they're all very, very healthy. Three of them can't hear, but they're very, very healthy. You know, so we help them, you know, manage their assets and plan for distribution planning. Estate planning is a big thing. Massachusetts still has a very low estate tax, so federally you have to be worth more than $5.5 million. Massachusetts is only $1 million, which is not unusual with the value of real estate, you know, in our communities. So we work with individuals there, life insurance, annuities, investments. So we're a closely held business. We feel the pain of business, the regulatory environment, you know, whether it be on the federal or state level. Again, if you're a small business owner, you deal with those things. So so I'm involved with the chamber. I'm the treasurer of the Chamber of Commerce. So I work with Dave very closely. You know, we've done a lot of the last few years with Pembroke Days, which, you know, some of you have participated in, hope to continue to support. Hopefully it's going to get bigger and better every year. We've worked with Chief Wallen Hill in that area. And the sheriff has always been great to bring in his command vehicle. And we're working with, I think, the reserves to bring in some of their equipment this year. So want to make that a better run for the town. And also ask the board, is there anything, you know, from the chamber's perspective that, you know, we can do better or things to assist the town? You know,
we need your address and your telephone number so people can get a hold of you.
Sure. I'm at 300 Oak Street, which is Corporate Park, right across from Tomasi Nursery, Suite 220, of course, in Pembroke. Phone number is 781-924-5684. And if you want to call me directly at extension 201, I answer my own phone. We don't screen them.
Very good. Ed, might want to just mention to the board that we tried to initiate a recycling program with the businesses, and Dave had appointed Kyle Horney to be the representative, and a couple of the members of the former recycling committee had kind of spearheaded that, but Dave kind of, like, you know, dropped their interest in it. So that's something that, as the landfill manager and I were doing our annual DEP report online today, that was one of the things that, you know, we had to check off that we didn't do, but we certainly want to partner with the chamber about having businesses in the community
be involved in the town's recycling program.
Yeah. Recycling is a challenge for businesses because every, for example, our business, we're pretty much paperless. We get a lot of paper in the door, we scan it, we give it back to the clients. We do generate some paper internally. Most of what we generate internally, we have to shred. We have a company, just like in medical offices, we shred. But I mean, there are a lot of, like in Corporate Park, there's no like central area where we could bring in cardboard or what have you. And we did that, those types of issues came up when the recycling, there's two gentlemen, I believe,
right,
that they came to us, and I don't know where that was left. I wasn't.
It was left with me.
Okay. Yeah, we'd be glad to revisit that.
Absolutely.
And if there was some type of coordinated way to, especially like in Corporate Park, where there could be a central area there, if you talk to the owners of the park and said, is there somehow cardboard or glass or whatever, you know, could be, you know, better handled versus going into everybody's dumpster.
Okay. Very good.
Good. Did you have anything else for us?
No, that was great. Again, welcome for the opportunity. And I didn't want to leave Matt on that. We haven't met before, but you know.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice meeting you too. So thank you very much.
Well, thank you for coming in. And just to let the public know, this was an idea from the board to meet with the president of the Chamber of Commerce and get some two-way conversation going so that the chamber members could have an opportunity to tell the residents of Pembroke what they do, what their business is, and like to have a two-way street. I know that you like to work with the town, and the town likes to work with the chamber. So we should be letting the public know who's in the Chamber of Commerce and what they do, what services are available to the residents of Pembroke.
Correct.
And we're off to a very good start. And thank you very much for coming in.
Just to remind people, the public, that they can always go to the Chamber website. As all the members of business, if you're looking for a certain category, whether it be legal, accounting, retail, restaurants, our Chamber members are right in there, that website. So they can, they want to, you know, see the people that support the town, they give back. A lot of our, you know, members give back in many, many ways to the community, whether it be sponsoring Little League teams or all the different events that we have, Pembroke Days. We have a lot of people that really give a lot of, you know, time and treasure to these events. And we want to continue doing that because it's good for the town. It's really good for the town. And Pembroke's a great town. I've really enjoyed, you know, living here since 1994. I don't miss Situate that much.
Very good.
Thank you very much. For coming
in.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming in.
Thank you, Ed, for giving up your time. We'd like to go back to you now for anything else that you wanted to talk to us about.
You know, we're having problems with right now trying to hammer out this intergovernment agreement with the town of Hanson regarding joint animal control services. So, you know, hopefully we'll have it all prepared. You know, their attorney made some suggestions. Our guy made some suggestions, and so we're still kind of trying to hammer it out. The concept is that, you know, we, with the town of Hanson, would share our animal control officer and an assistant that would be funded by the town of Hanson, so that our ACO would have, you know, a qualified assistant to handle a lot of the paperwork, handle some of the duties at the animal shelter. So we're still working on some of the, you know, some of the nuances of the agreement. So
Ed, town, Abington and Rockland or Whitman and Rockland come to mind, but I'm not certain, have just shared an animal control officer.
Right.
So there's, if you need to plagiarize the municipal agreement.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
There's a place to go to.
And Hanson was in with Whitman and Abington, I believe. But three towns was a little too much for one person.
Yes.
You know, and so that, and Hanson felt like, you know, they weren't getting a big bang for their buck. So the town administrator, Mike McHugh, had approached me about it. And so we've been talking about it. We had a couple of meetings about this. And so we're just trying to hammer out an intergovernmental agreement that's satisfactory for both towns. I believe Norwell and maybe Situate and another town in that neighborhood, you know, are also sharing animal control services, so.
And we're looking for a special agreement. We're keyed on one particular aspect of the contract that we're trying to hammer out.
Mm-hmm.
Other than most towns wouldn't be looking at that particular agreement.
Yeah, well, you know, we want the agreement to be successful, and we want to make sure that there are no questions when a situation arises about, you know, liability and indemnification, things like that, that we're just, that, you know, the attorneys on both sides. But, you know, we'll definitely have an agreement for the board when they meet next.
So you see the benefits of this as saving money?
We'll probably have, without having to spend more town money, we will provide administrative and assistance to our current animal control officer without us spending. And in the case of Hanson, they'll get a certified animal control officer for what they're spending in their budget, because they don't have one right now.
Very good.
Dan.
Seven.
Right. We can finish up here.
Okay.
Thank you for letting me.
All right. I just wanted to remind Dan that he has another meeting to go to, a town government study committee. Very important, and Dan is our representative on that committee. Under Ask the Selectmen, does anyone have any issues there? I thought I'll make a brief one. As you may know, I live on Oak Street, and I've gotten a lot of calls and comments from my fellow neighbors about, at the end of Oak Street, the clearing of the land as you go around the corner heading toward Corporate Park. Well, it turns out that the developer is planning on doing something with that property, but he hasn't been before the planning board with any kind of a plan, just a short discussion about what he may be doing there. The issue I have is that he's cut down all the trees and all of the vegetation. And in speaking with the building inspector, we have a bylaw that he has to get a permit to do that. Now, there is a fine associated with having not done that. And so we are looking at that. There is currently no official plan for what he wants to do there before the planning board as yet. So there will be a development there of some type sometime in the future. So to my fellow neighbors, that's what's going on there on Oak Street. Is there any new business? Upcoming issues for the board. February 27th, Gail Sim from the First Church in Pembroke will be requesting the use of the Town Memorial Green. Also on the 27th, the Planning Board will be holding two public hearings, one at 7 and one at 7:30 here in Veterans Hall. And on March 27th, Jennifer Mathias will be here to give us an update on the project at Hill Bog, project that has been going on for quite a while. We've requested a six-month update on that project, and we're a little over on that, but she will be in to tell us what's going on there. Do we have a need for executive session?
Very briefly, but I can tell Mr. Trabucco the synopsis tomorrow on the phone.
You sure?
Positive. There's not any decisions that are going to be made. There's nothing earth shattering.
Okay. So do I have a motion for executive session?
So moved.
Mr. Chairman, I'll move that we enter executive session to discuss strategy with respect to collective bargaining or litigation. If an open meeting may have a detrimental effect on the bargaining or litigating position of the public body, and the chair so declares. And it's listed as clerical, DPW, police, and fire.
And the chair does declare.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor, Dan?
Yes.
Matthew?
Yes.
Bill?
Yes.
Arthur?
Yes.
And I vote yes. There will be no need to return to public session, I do not believe, for any vote. So The last announcement I would like to make to the public is that we will have no Selectmen's meeting on Monday, February 20th, due to President's Day. So we will not be meeting again until the 27th of February at 7 p.m. Excuse me, I believe that will be 6:30 p.m. on the 27th.
May I just have one thing?
Yes, Bill.
There is starting to be a little bit of ice on the ponds now. It is freezing over a little bit. We've noticed that there has been a couple of people that have gone through the ice in snowmobiles, and there has been a few drownings and stuff. So keep your eye on your kids and your animals and all that, and try to keep them off the ice because it definitely is not safe. So.
So thanks for that reminder, Bill. That could be a very dangerous situation. Well, thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you on Monday, the 27th, at 6:30.